I will be talking about Dr. Bennett Omolu, a Nigerian-American neuropathologist and with whom I identify as my biology role model. Dr. Omolu was born in Nwoka, in Nigeria, on September 30th of 1968. He first became involved in the scientific field when he attended medical college at age 16 at the University of Nigeria, Enugu. He first came to the U.S. in 1994 to complete an epidemiology fellowship at the University of Washington in Seattle, then went to Columbia University's Harlem Hospital Center for a degree in anatomic and clinical pathology. He was formally trained as a forensic pathologist at Allegheny County Coroner's Office in Pittsburgh and is a current professor of clinical pathology at the University of California, Davis. He holds 8 advanced degrees and certifications. His most significant obstacle that he has had to overcome regard his findings concluding that former NFL players had diagnosed cases of chronic traumatic encephalopathy, a neurodegenerative disease caused by repeated blows to the head. This was not formally recognized by the NFL until 2016, almost 15 years after his initial studies. Dr. Omolu is somewhat famous in pop culture, as his findings regarding CTE in former NFL players and his subsequent publications were dramatized and made into the 2015 film Concussion, starring Will Smith. Dr. Omolu has since stated that some of the events depicted in the movie were not wholly accurate and were overdramatized. What I identify most with Dr. Omolu is, based on his research done on football players and his constant push to make sports safer, he has published 2 books and multiple papers on the dangers of repeated head trauma and is an advocate for player safety regarding head injuries in major contact sports, especially in the NFL. I admire Dr. Omolu most because of his constant push to make contact sports safer for players, despite his findings being initially dismissed. His work with CTE studies has shown the sustained effects of chronic head injuries, and as someone who has had multiple concussions, I feel I can relate to his work and his push to make head injuries a more of a major concern due to long-term effects. The field Dr. Omolu is most closely associated with is clinical pathology, and more specifically, neuropathology. Dr. Omolu's research seeks to find the links between chronic head injuries and CTE and determine the lasting health effects. More recently, he has also done research to better diagnose CTE in the hopes that it can be recognized while the patient is still alive. The most recent paper that Dr. Omolu is an author on was In Vivo Characterization of Chronic Traumatic Encephalopathy Using F18, FDDNP, PET Brain Imaging. He was the lead author of a study that confirmed CTE in a living person by using the chemical tracer FDDNP to bind to tau protein in brain tissue. Tau protein builds up as a result of CTE and causes neurodegradation. Dr. Omolu's research was able to successfully image these protein deposits without autopsy. Dr. Omolu's autopsies of former NFL players has uncovered a long-term link between players and CTE, as well as he has discovered potential methods of diagnosing this disease in patients who are still alive. He now acts as an advocate for player safety in the NFL and other contact sports, and further research is being done to treat or cure neurodegenerative diseases, such as CTE, but also other diseases such as Alzheimer's or dementia. And this, overall, is why Dr. Omolu is my biology role model.